I'm here with Albert Kirshner at Two Bar Distillery, Spirits and Soto. We're hanging out. You guys should come on down here. I made great booze. I say that every single time. Albert, how did you like your vodka, your bourbon, your moonshine?
It's That's the best bourbon I've ever had.
The best bourbon he's ever had. This is a good bourbon.
I am new to drinking adult liquors, and this made me like whiskey.
He's an adult now. He grew up. This beer just started like 15 minutes ago. Albert is here to promote his show at the Can Can Cabaret, his show Comedy Mystery and Mutants. Albert, you want to give us a little...
Every third Wednesday at 7:30 in the best basement in Seattle. What we do is I bring three stand-up comedians, and between them, anything, really. Any sort of performance art, anything that's funny, a lot of risk-taking by comics, usually. Just do something different for me, and if it doesn't go well, I don't care. I just want you to have tried something you wanted to do.
It's really weird and crazy, and it's fun. And they have a great bar there. The bartender makes fantastic drinks. Had a Manhattan there, it was incredible. He used the actual maraschino cherries that were soaked in brandy.
Jay is incredible. He's usually...
Yeah, Jay. Great guy.
Actually, can I mention something about this show specifically?
Go for it.
So, because it's a burlesque, it's usually a burlesque and sometimes music bar, they get a lot of bachelorette parties and birthday parties. So that means that I get a lot of bachelorette parties and birthday parties. And I got an email from the Can-Can this month saying, hey, we have a bachelorette party, and their like brother or someone is paying us extra to have you write something for her in the show. Which, as a stand-up, is just very frustrating. But to kind of show her the flavor of our show, maybe this wasn't the best idea, I decided to... hire two street musicians, terrifying little men that play really incredible blues guitars, actually. I really wish I brought on a piece of paper with their names, because they're wonderful. But they're scary visually, very terrifying. So we're going to have them serenade her while I improv a really just kind of dark and dumb blues song about being married. And then we're going to have the scariest characters that we've had on the show kind of slowly circle her. So we're giving her what she wanted, but in that obnoxious, a genie granting you a wish, but you didn't really think it out too much thing.
So make sure you watch that. It'll be horrible for her. It'll be very funny for everyone else. And go check the show. It's going to be on Bumbershoot, actually. So that's
really cool.
They got on Bumbershoot. So make sure you get down and check out one of the shows. Now, Albert, why have you here? I'm going to throw out something I was thinking about. Because I picked up something that the lamestream media has completely gone over. And I think it's about time that someone's picked it up. And I think you and I are the people to do it here. So there's something that I have noticed that I thought that maybe you and I could talk about a bit. Sherwin-Williams logo is the most terrifying thing in the world, and nobody
but
cares.
But Travis, they just sell paint!
No, it's not just paint. Look at this logo. What is that? That is aggressive. That is the most aggressive.
That is a bucket of red liquid covering the globe.
Have you ever actually looked at it before?
And said, cover the earth. That's their model?
Cover the earth with the blood of the innocents.
That is just, it's just blood covering a globe, and it says cover the earth. And even if they're in their head, that's paint, then you're what, you're just paint, you're killing the earth with paint?
Paint's not good for the earth. There's a lot of chemicals, and that's not good for anyone. And they even abbreviated the logo on the bucket, SWP. That looks like a dangerous organization. So here's something that I did for you, because Comedy Mystery Mutants, great show. What you need is a corporate sponsorship. So what I've done here is designed this logo, and you'll see it's a baby holding a paintbrush. Just a bit of paint. Just a bit. That's all you need, Sherwin-Williams. Just enough to finish the job.
Just a bit.
Very very nice for a baby to have a paintbrush.
Oh, you mean I only need enough paint to cover my walls, not to dominate the entire world?
Yeah, no, we're not drowning babies in paint. It's just a
wildly different attitude about just painting. Yeah. Oh, by the way, all this just about fucking painting.
Yeah, but they're probably going to mess up the logo. I could send them this, and then they're just going to switch it so the baby has red eyes and is bleeding.
Oh my God. Maybe the baby's being covered in it. I
want to think they're good people. I want to think they're good people.
What era was that designed at? Because it seems it comes from a time when having a giant penis and conquering the world was what everyone was about, and then now we're maybe a little more chill about it, hopefully. Not every company needs to be the one that just devastates everything else.
Yeah.
All the competition. You buy our paint or your family goes to hell.